Coach, you've been very successful, like with Andre Ward, with the Olympic gold and the amateur style and the professional. Look, Andre Ward hasn't lost in 12 years. What's next for Andre right now? Do you know?
Well, I think he's scheduled to go in May. We don't have an opponent yet, but look, Andre's going to be the pound for pound number one fighter in the world. I hear a lot of, with all due respect, I hear a lot of fighters saying that. And, you know, Andre's up against a lot of things right now, but these are things that he's going to overcome. These are the things that's going to be delivered to him. He's going to be the best fighter in the world when it's all said and done. So what he's doing right now is what he's always done. He's applying his craft. He stays in the gym. He's getting better and better and better. The world has only seen about 80% of what he can do. We just had a successful shoulder surgery on an injury that's been bothering him since he's been 12 years old. So Andre Ward is going to have the world in his hands, the boxing world in his hands. It's just a matter of time. Each fight is going to be obvious.
The last question, Coach. There's a lot of talk of Floyd Mayweather, Amir Khan. It hasn't been announced yet. Many people that I talk to, they write off Amir, which I don't know why they're doing it. He's a champion. He has the speed. He has power. Working with Amir and being close around them, what do you think of that fight with Mayweather, if it happens?
Well, you know, I told Amir when the possibility of that fight came up that if he continued to not train in between fights, that this was going to be a very difficult fight and a fight that could really have him questioning himself. But I also told him that if he would train in between fights and apply his craft and work on his flaws, that he can make this fight, he can put himself in a position of winning the fight. And it's not that he'll never have Floyd's boxing IQ because Floyd has just been doing it longer and he's been more dedicated to his craft. But all credit to Amir. He told me personally, he said, Coach, you know, I never knew I was supposed to work out in between fights, you know. But now that you're telling me, I'm going to do it. So I've seen such growth in him since he's committed to that, anybody who writes Amir Khan, I'm just going to be a fool. Amir Khan can do some things that no other fighter can do, just like Andre Ward can do some things that no other fighter can do. And I coach both of them, so I know what I'm talking about. He can do some things that no other fighter can do. And these things are becoming more and more apparent. So, you know, at this stage, if Amir gets that fight, it's going to be the toughest fight Floyd's had in a while, and it could quite possibly surprise a lot of people.
You know what I mean? Almost.
Before I let you go, there was Amir said that if it's not Floyd, he would like Manny Pacquiao. Would you like that fight for Amir Khan, Manny Pacquiao, Amir Khan?
Well, I think that is a fight that makes sense also. I mean, Manny is, you know, it's getting harder and harder for them to get opponents, and people want to see these fights, and I think the world would want to see Manny Pacquiao and Amir Khan. It would be a great, great fight, and one thing about Amir, he'll fight anybody, and that's the credit that I give him, so I would definitely back that fight up.
There you have it. 2013 was a great year. 2014, even better, Coach.
Thanks.
There you have it. Stay tuned. Virgil Under, one of the best in the business. FeasonReport.com and Melissa Clark reporting.
Thank you.